The hassle of dealing with grow lights almost made me give up on gardening. You too. Luckily, I found a better way to start seeds. Instead of forking out money for even moderately priced grow lights, you can start your spring and summer garden for just pennies using milk jugs. It's cheap, it's simple, and there's virtually no maintenance. Better yet, it actually works. In this video, I'll share the how-tos and the don't do's in 10 easy steps so that you can have a successful garden using materials that you probably already have around the house. Let's get to it. But first, if you're unfamiliar with the why and how winter sowing works, let me take a quick minute to explain in very simple terms. But if you're good to go, jump to the timestamp that I'll include. Winter sowing is the process of placing seeds inside of containers to create a mini greenhouse that is kept outdoors. And it's especially enticing for those of us that don't have a lot of room for sowing seeds indoors. You know, because you need tables or tiered racks and grow flats and drip trays and grow lights. Or you just prefer to avoid expensive of grow light purchases, but you still want to be able to grow from seed. And that's really important for me because I love growing heirlooms that I can't get from my local nursery. Winter sowing allows seeds to get better germination rates, it's excellent for cool season vegetables and herbs, and is inexpensive. A milk jug provides plants with their own individual greenhouse that creates and maintains the ideal microclimate that a seed needs to germinate. This is really important for your cool weather crops that have to go through this process of hardening off. But in a milk jug that's kept outdoors, it naturally experiences the outdoor conditions that it needs. This outdoor exposure stops seed dormancy and triggers germination more successfully than seeds that are grown indoors. So, how do you plant your seeds in milk jugs? Here's the process in 10 easy steps. First, select your containers. You can almost select anything to grow in as long as it's opaque, meaning the sun can get through. Plastic milk jugs are a popular choice because they provide a dome shape that lets in plenty of light, traps heat and moisture, and are easy enough to get your hands on. Some other examples include takeout containers, water jugs, 2-liter soda bottles, and rotisserie chicken containers. Next, prepare your containers. Wash, rinse, and clean your containers with a mild dish soap to remove any residue. Then puncture the center of the container, or around 5 to 6 inches from the bottom, and cut around the middle, leaving about a half inch to act as a hinge. Next, create a pattern of drainage holes on the base of the container using a drill or paring knife. Go ahead and recycle the caps because you won't need them. Next, you'll need your soil. Potting soil, that is. Believe me, it's not something that you want to substitute. These seeds will be sitting outside, so an indoor seed starting mix will be too light and regular garden soil will be too heavy. Potting soil is your Goldilocks fit. Add a minimum of 4 inches of damp soil to each container. Planting needs to be done in soil that is neither too dry nor soggy. Using damp soil will ensure your plants won't dry out or die and provide sufficient root growing space. Now it's time to sprinkle your seeds. Sprinkle your seeds on the surface of the soil. You want to add enough seeds to ensure you have successful germinations, but not so many that you crowd things out and end up with a mess to untangle later on. Check the seed packet to see how deep to plant. Gently pat the seeds to press into the surface of the soil and sprinkle a very thin layer of damp potting mix on top. Now it's time to lock and label. Use 2 to 3 wraps of duct tape to seal the container. Use a permanent marker to label your container. Now I recommend labeling your container in at least 2 places, such as the top and the bottom of your container, because even permanent markers fade over time, especially when exposed to light. But as an alternative, you can also use a paint pen, which is least likely to fade in UV light and cold, wet conditions. Next, it's time to allow your containers to soak up the sun. Place your containers in an area where they'll get the most amount of sun if you live in a moderately cold condition, or partial sun if you live in a milder climate. Once your seedlings germinate, this location will give them the right amount of sun exposure. Now here's a pro tip. I strongly recommend storing your jugs either in a milk crate or some other shallow container to avoid the chance of strong winds coming by and completely knocking over all of your containers. That would be a tragedy of unbearable measure. All right, so now we're on to step 7 where you're gonna hurry up and
wait.
Yep, this is exactly what you'll do. Now be sure to check on your plants weekly, but you'll observe absolutely nothing for weeks.
4 months.
And that's to be expected. In this case, no news is good news. But behold, one glorious day you will see something sprout. You will see green. But this is also when you have to switch from passive to active mode. As your seedlings grow, they're gonna start to need more air circulation. So you'll either have to puncture the top of the container or add more drainage holes. For some folks, they'll even cut out a ventilation window. And also at this point, you may need to start watering your soil so that the seedlings stay moist. For step 9, you're gonna need to keep some blankets close.
Yes, this is your blanket, Mama knows.
And this is because sometimes the weather is sporadic. Scratch that, weather is sporadic. Once you have seedlings, an unexpected cold spell can knock out all your hard work. That's why I recommend keeping a covering like an old blanket or burlap or frost cloth to cover your containers anytime the weather will dip below 40 degrees. We are already at step 10, which is to transplant your seedlings to the garden or their containers. Once your seedlings start to touch the top of the containers and their roots are 1 to 2 inches long, they're ready for the garden. See how easy that was? To get more gardening and self-sufficiency tips to help you live a farm-fresh life without land or livestock, consider joining me here weekly. I'll see you in my kitchen or garden soon.